Hey everybody, Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com, our update for Thursday, April 4th, 2019. Free pick coming up in just a moment. If you've yet to become a member over at DocSports.com, real cool way to give it a trial run. You click on the link below the video, get set up for a free $60 account. You can use those free 60 bucks on any of my daily packages or anybody else over at DocSports.com. Again, it all starts by clicking on the link below the video. Real quick recap from last night. We're going to jump into some NFL stuff, and we're also going to get to that free pick in a moment. But the recap last night, just one of those nights where we had a crap night. You know, the NBA, we went into Wednesday on a 6-0 run and 17-3 with our last 20. Well, it's now 6-1 and 17-4 as we lost last night with the Detroit Pistons. As far as Major League Baseball is concerned, we were involved in two games, and it really sucks when you've got a lead with your team going into the other team's final at-bat, and you get beat not just once, but twice. We got beat in both games last night in our opponent's final at bat. And what you kind of tend to do is you take a lot of notes and you jot down whether it was an anomaly for a bullpen to give up the kind of runs that they did in the final at bat with leads not being able to hold them. And if it was an anomaly, then you obviously look to play on those teams in similar situations, you know, next time out or a couple of days down the road. If it looks like this is going to be an issue and a trend for certain bullpens, then obviously you make notes of that and you tend to potentially play against those teams in those kind of situations or at least stay away from those games. One of those games last night we had was the Cubs, who were an underdog last night, and they're up 4-2 going to the bottom half of the eighth, and they give up, when they give up four runs in the bottom of the eighth, and that bullpen's just struggling right now. So anyway, just one of those pissy kind of nights where you've got a team going into the other team's final at bat and you've got a lead. And the leads get blown, not just once, but in two games. And we don't bitch, we don't whine too much. This is a rare situation for us. But again, I wanted to talk about it from a learning experience. You jot down the notes, you see what happened. If it looks to be something that's trending against a bullpen, obviously, again, you look to play against those teams in that spot again down the road or stay away from their games. It's just one of those things, one-time thing, that obviously you jump back on those teams, maybe get a little value with them after they blow a game or two in the early portion of the season. So what's going on for Thursday for me over at DocSports.com? Well, I've got the NIT championship game. I've got the side between Lipscomb and Texas. We thought we might wait till Saturday for our next premium pick, but we like where the line is. We like the matchup, obviously. And the side will be available Thursday morning, DocSports.com at 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific. Go grab it anytime after that. So we're back in college basketball action on Thursday with the NIT championship. We've also got Major League Baseball, and just a quick note, it's an afternoon game, a daytime dominator, as we like to call them, on Thursday slate, and that baseball side will also be available same time as the basketball play, 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific. Go grab that, and we'll be back in the NHL on Thursday. We passed on Wednesday night. We're right back in action on Thursday. It does involve a couple of teams that have some things they can gain or lose when it comes to the NHL postseason. We've got one game in the NHL for Thursday. So baseball, college basketball's NIT championship, the NHL, all available Thursday morning over at DocSports.com. We look for the 3-0 sweep. Real quick note, some were asking about NASCAR. It'll generally be available on Saturday nights throughout the course of the entire season, which runs all the way into November. And we'll let you know on Saturday morning's video about the time that we'll post that on Saturday night. This week they go to Bristol. The AAF, unfortunately, has folded. We were 67% on our run in the Alliance of American Football. It's done. It's out of here. And that's just the way it goes sometimes. We'll look forward to seeing what the XFL has to offer next year when they get things underway, and maybe they can work on some kind of deal with the NFL. But speaking of the NFL, you saw one particular book in Nevada, CG Sportsbooks, post-NFL wins totals a few days ago. They've got the Patriots with the highest wins total of 11. The lowest are the Cardinals and the Dolphins. They are both at 5 wins. The Pats probably are not going to be challenged again in their division. In the AFC East, you've got the Dolphins at 5 wins. The Bills posted at 6 wins. The Jets posted at 7 wins. So it's not like one of those teams is going to finally catch New England. But as far as the upstart teams from last year, the Super Bowl runner-up, the Rams, and also in the AFC, the Kansas City Chiefs, are both listed at 10.5 wins. Here's what I wanted to offer up as far as how to handicap wins totals in the NFL and what you kind of want to look at. Don't pay attention to what happened last year so much. Don't look at those records and give too much weight to those. And I'll give you a perfect example. You want to look at where the books have teams season win totals for this upcoming year when you're looking to plunk down some money on NFL win totals. Let's say, for instance, you are involved in a team or you want to bet on a team that's taking on the New York Jets on their schedule, whether it be a divisional team where they have to play them twice or whether it be just one game if they're not in the same division. Well, here's why you don't want to look at what those teams did last year when it comes to projecting how teams are going to fare in the upcoming season. Last year, the Jets finished 4-12 straight up. This year, check out the CG Sportsbook's wins totals. They've got the Jets at 7 wins with juice on the over. So you're talking, you know, they're expecting the Jets to get 3 more wins. At least that's where the wins total is. And again, the juice on the over. And so that's what you want to do. Don't write down that the Jets went 4-12 last year and that's how you're judging New England's wins totals or Miami's or Buffalo's teams that play the Jets twice. Jot down where the sports books have those wins totals for the upcoming season. Gives you a better gauge of where these teams are going into the upcoming year and gets you to looking ahead rather than looking in the past. And that's what's been best for me. And I've been much better at NFL wins totals since I started doing that many, many years ago, rather than paying too much, again, weight or credence to what happened in the previous season. So just some thoughts on the NFL wins totals. We're not really going to jump into it any more than that until we get all the schedules broken down on when teams are playing certain games, when their bye weeks are, all that kind of stuff, scheduling tough spots, scheduling good spots for teams. And we'll start talking a little bit about that down the road a little bit. But just wanted to talk a little bit about how maybe to approach your NFL wins totals and what has worked for me over the last several seasons. Let's get to the free pick for Thursday. We're going to turn to Major League Baseball West Coast late night action. We're going to recommend a play on the Angels over the Rangers. Angels laying about $1.45 as I cut this video. And listen, you got Matt Harvey on the mound. Off to a nice start in his first season with the Angels. Tonight he's going to be on the home bump as the Angels open up their home season. Listen, here's the thing. They're going up against Edinson Volquez, who has not pitched on a regular basis since early July of 2017, 2 years ago. He struggled in his first start against the Cubs. He gave up 10 base runners, 4 walks, 6 hits in just 4 innings, and he gave up 4 earned runs in those 4 innings pitched. And in fact, it took 80 pitches just to get through 4 innings for Volquez. So we expect him to continue to struggle a little bit. Listen, I know the Angels lineup isn't 100% healthy, but if anybody's going to provide a springboard to some offensive output for this Angel team right now before they get healthy, we think it'll be Volquez. So we're going to recommend a play on the Angels. They're right now laying about $1.45, team 970, the Angels. And again, that game goes a little bit after 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Pacific on Thursday night. Hey, don't forget about Thursday slate. Daytime action in Major League Baseball over at DocSports.com for me. We've also got the NIT Championship. We've got the NHL. Let's go 3-0 on Thursday. The baseball play and the college basketball play available at 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific time on Thursday. Go grab that on Thursday morning. If you like what you see with these videos, be sure to click on that thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. We do appreciate those who have done so thus far. And when you subscribe, you don't miss out on any of the videos. A winner here last night. Let's do it again with the Angels tonight. I'm Scott Spreitzer, DocSports.com. Let's put Thursday in the win column. We're right back here Friday morning about 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific.